Alternative Blend is made possible through the generous underwriting support of The Green Solution.
We're joined now by one of Dr. Dave's patients who says that her ability to function as a mother, or frankly function at all, is largely due to Dr. Dave and his protocol. So I'd like to introduce her. I can't wait for you to hear her story. Welcome.
Hi.
This is Angie Lawrence,
yes.
Right? Have I got that right? Angie, you know, we talked a bit before the show, and your story is absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
I want to start with, there's so much to tell, but let's start at age 26. You mm-hmm. were diagnosed with a very, very rare illness. Can you tell us about that?
Yes. It's called systemic mastocytosis. I actually have a non-cancerous version of it, but it's basically a disease where I'm allergic to so many things, almost everything I'm allergic to.
Almost everything. And it wasn't until age 26 that you discovered this.
Correct. And I didn't have allergy symptoms like that before. It just kind of
came on at age 26. And you know, there's a lot to this story, so I'm going to have to speed it up a little bit. But mm-hmm. I do want to say that it, really to get this final diagnosis, to really understand it, you had to go to the Mayo Clinic.
Yes, I did.
To be diagnosed.
Yes.
And then what were the symptoms of this? What kinds of things would you suffer?
I had uncontrollable nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal pain, hives. And it was really bad. It was multiple times a day, every day.
And then your ability to function became just
it was
non-existent.
Yes.
At some point. And then somewhere along the line, it was further complicated because you had a doctor who wanted to test your bone marrow for something?
Yes.
Tell me what happened.
In order to decipher whether I had a cancerous version of the systemic mastocytosis, mm-hmm. I had to have a bone marrow biopsy. And that procedure got messed up because the needle bent going into my iliac crest on my hip bone. And when it did, it kind of ripped a hole in my spinal sac, and I lost all my spinal fluid.
Oh,
so I couldn't really stand up to even walk after that.
And was it a period of time before that, would it grow back? Would the fluid refill? I mean, what was the prognosis?
The way that the rip was, it would just have to heal on its own. There was no way that they could fix it.
So at that point, you couldn't stand, you couldn't walk, you had complicated issues now as a result of this, and you're still dealing with the original set of issues.
Correct.
And then 3 days into this, you have a stroke.
Correct.
Oh my gosh, Angie, tell me about that. What happened?
I woke up really early in the morning and I was like, something just doesn't feel right. I feel like I'm in a brain fog. And my left arm went numb and tingly. So I was like, oh man, I'm having a heart attack. Yeah. I went to the first aid kit and took some aspirin and then called 911. And by the time the ambulance got there, I couldn't feel the entire left side of my body.
Oh my goodness.
And so they took me to the hospital. And while I was in the ambulance, I started having seizures. And that's actually something that I've been dealing with since the stroke.
So let me get this right. You have this originally diagnosed disease that is a very rare illness, still without answers.
Correct.
Then you had this, you know, burst of your spinal fluid sac that caused you to not be able to walk, and you had increased issues with just your bodily functions.
Correct.
Then you had a stroke as a result of the stress on your body. This is all at age 26.
Yes.
And out of that, you have a little bit of brain damage and you have a post-stroke seizures.
Correct.
And all of that, at this point in time, you're still dealing with all of it.
Yes.
So in chasing solutions for the first problem, now you have two or three or four more that are layered upon
Absolutely.
This. And then traditional medical doctors were not really helping you, right? I mean,
no.
They were putting you on pharmaceuticals. Tell me what you were taking.
Oh, I saw so many specialists all over Colorado. I was taking a very high dosage of my seizure medicine called Keppra. I was taking 1,500 milligrams twice a day. They also had me on Klonopin, which is something that's normally just like to calm you down after, you know, like a panic attack or something like that, but not prolonged, and I was on it for a prolonged time.
Oh my goodness.
In addition to that, I take all my allergy medications, anti-nausea medicines, pills.
I don't know how you could function with pain pills. How do you function with all that? Were you functioning?
Not very well.
But to add to all of this, miracle upon miracles, you got pregnant.
I did.
And that, again, another layer of complications. You ended up in the hospital in that first trimester because you simply could not keep water or food down?
Yes, I was absolutely getting super dehydrated. So they just hospitalized me, gave me a PICC line in my arm, and would just give me round-the-clock fluids all the
time.
And
this baby was in jeopardy.
Yes, she was.
And so it was this point in time, that I think it was your dad.
Yes.
Who suggested, why don't you try cannabis? Because he understood that that may be help for nausea.
Yes.
So what happened?
So I did. I was like, okay, let's see where this goes. I tried it, and my nausea stopped almost instantly with that, so that I was able to leave the hospital and continue functioning. I still did have to go every once in a while to get added fluids, but for the most part, my nausea became, over time, null and nothing.
And then, and you took this baby to term.
I did.
And she's now 8 years old.
She is.
And what's her name?
Her name is Lily.
And she's your little miracle baby.
Yes, she is.
I think that's just an amazing story. But still, even with all this, and she was healthy and you went on, but you were still dealing with a multitude of health issues.
Yes.
And at some point in time, that's when you went back to see Dr. Dave. Now, I say
correct.
Went back because years before, you actually worked for Dr. Dave.
I did.
But you weren't a patient.
No.
At that time. So now you're off, you're having all these complicated issues that are happening in your life, and no one was helping you.
No.
And Dr. Dave, that's where you come in the picture.
Yeah, exactly.
And I want you to tell the story that this is not unusual. Patients like her who got kind of kicked to the curb by the medical. Tell me that's.
Yeah, I mean, her individual story is certainly unique.
Sure.
But it's a very common thing for people who have complex disorders or disorders that don't even have a name. The medical system just kind of says, well, our pills don't work for you, so therefore you don't exist, kind of. And so she was struggling. None of the, you know, initially a lot of these medicines weren't working. Mm-hmm. And I think initially, you know, wasn't using potentially cannabis as much as she could have because she was being told by her doctors, no, you got to take these pills, you got to take these pills.
Right.
So she'd keep ending up in the emergency room, and then the emergency room would just be like, oh, we can't do anything for you, just leave. And it was this cycle where really nobody was helping her.
It was like the pills that they were giving me were kind of like putting a Band-Aid on it, whereas instead of looking for a root cause, like
right.
Dr. Dave started to do.
Well, that's the thing that began the road to the recovery. Although you're not completely recovered, your quality of life went from, I don't know, 2 to 10.
Absolutely.
In terms of being able to function. I mean, you look perfectly healthy today.
Thank you.
And I know this was not a you know, an easy road to get here. But doctor, what did you do to help her? What were the solutions?
I mean, similar ones that we use in patients even with less complex stuff. Mm-hmm. A lot of it is looking at root cause and say, you have this overactive immune system. Mm-hmm. How do we quiet that down? So we start avoiding things that are triggering your immune system, and at least some of the key things. So a lot of that's food. Mm-hmm. A lot of that is doing steps to, again, quiet the body down. So whether it's breathing work, whether it's just, you know, working with, getting in nature, getting outside, those types of factors. Mm-hmm. And then she would be able to use cannabis a little bit more to feel better. Okay, now I can go for that walk. Now I can, prepare those foods, because she had a pretty strict diet she had to follow because of so many allergies.
No doubt.
And so it's just kind of continuing to build off that. And it's not like in a month she was great. I mean, this has been going on for, really almost 10 years now since mm-hmm. she's been able to implement a lot of these protocols. And it's just every 3 to 6 months, you're a little bit better. You're a little bit better. And you just have to keep working at it. And that's really the key thing. There's no magic. You just have to incorporate the wide array of things to help get at the root cause and control what's going on.
Well, you know, she's a perfect example of what you talked about in our first segment, which is the cannabis being a, sort of a gateway toward these other things. Like if you can get around the nausea, if you can begin to keep down fluids, if you can begin to feel a little bit better, then you can layer on the next thing, getting you toward that health. That's exactly what you talked about. That's integrative medicine. That's functional medicine.
That's exactly the step I was able to take too. It was a little bit at a time, mm-hmm. small changes over time, and eventually my overall health became so much better.
And so how do you feel today?
I feel great. I feel so much better than I did. Absolutely great.
And what a difference has all of this made in your life in terms of raising your little girl?
Oh, it's amazing. Before, I would want to sleep all day. I'd want to be in bed all day. And of course, having a child, it's not conducive to raising a child happily and healthily. So since then, I take her swimming all the time. We go on walks all the time. We go to the park. We go to the museum.
You're living life.
I am living life.
And I'm so happy to hear that.
Yes.
We're out of time, but I'm so happy that you came in, here and shared your story with
Thank
everyone.
Thank you for
it's
having
an incredible
me.
Story. I mean, you credit the doc. He's a little uncomfortable with that because you also had to do the work.
Yeah.
And you did it. So together, you have a fully functioning, healthy individual sitting before me, and I'm so thankful and happy for you and Dr. Rachel.
Thank you.
The Alternative Blend is made possible through the generous underwriting support of The Green Solution.